Selling supplements is the number one monetizing strategy on social media. If you're scared of lectins, there's Lectin Shield, only $80 a bottle. If you're afraid of the spike protein, you can get spike support, not to be confused with anti-spike formula, which is for your fear of glucose spikes. There's also spike detox, aqua spike, and spike hardcore energy. Spike seems pretty popular among influencers. Another big one is boost. Boost your immunity, boost your health. Influencers love to boost. Talking about mitochondria is also a big hit for some reason. And of course, some even promise to boost your mitochondria, whatever that means. For every possible fear, somebody will sell you an expensive bottle of pills. But which of these do you actually need and which are just a money grab? There are basically two types of supplements. There are proprietary blends where it's only one person or one company that sells it. And that's where they come up with these gimmicky names. And it's usually a specific mix of a few vitamins, minerals, herbs, everything jumbled together. And then there's common supplements under some guy's brand. So it can be Dr. So-and-so's magnesium supplement or so-and-so's zinc supplement. So those you can buy anywhere, but the influencer slapped his face on the bottle. For proprietary formulas, the rule is very simple. Show me the evidence. They're selling something proprietary that nobody else sells. So the burden of proof is on them. It's not on you to show you that their supplement A is safe and B does anything of benefit. This means conducting a study, conducting a trial where you give a group of people the supplement, and ideally you have a control group that gets a placebo, and then you report the effects after some time. Now, the vast majority of influencers selling supplements never do this. If they did it, the few that do, it'll be mentioned right on the sales page. If they went out of their way to conduct a trial, they'll let you know. You don't need to scour the internet. But it's very rare that they do it. Now, why would that be? One, it takes time. Two, it costs money. But mainly, they figure they don't have to. Enough people will buy their supplement without seeing any actual evidence. So most of these concoctions being sold on social media, the influencer can't tell you that their supplement, the thing they're actually selling, does anything, or even that it's safe. So you can't know, and here's the thing, they don't know either. At the end of the day, the influencer doesn't know what the effect of the supplement he or she is selling really is, because they haven't tested it. Now, because they can't provide you with the actual evidence, they're gonna try to distract you with some shiny lights. Number one distraction strategy are testimonials. This is a must on these pages. Just show snippets of random people saying they felt all kinds of wonderful things after they took their pills. This works. Actually, it works quite well because most people don't realize how meaningless this is. Number one, there's no way for you to verify that these are even real. Anybody can type a testimonial. Even the sales team theoretically could do it. Number two, there's something called selection bias. Somebody that tries a supplement and feel something good, whether that's caused by the supplement or not, is much more likely to go on a page and type something enthusiastic than somebody who tried the supplement, felt nothing, and just went away, stopped buying it. And those might be 99% of the buyers. So this is why a trial is really important, because there you report the outcomes of everyone who took the supplement. It's an unbiased design. Number three, there's something called the placebo effect, which is very well documented and very robust. When we expect a benefit from something, we tend to feel better, even if the substance itself doesn't do anything. Bottom line, testimonials on a web page to sell you something are worth essentially zero. Another really common strategy is to use buzzwords. Just say it's natural. It's all natural. It's 100% natural. This works psychologically because we tend to associate natural with safe or even good and unnatural with bad. But natural doesn't necessarily mean something is safe. Plenty of natural things have detrimental effects. Some vitamin supplements like vitamin E can cause harm. Some herbs are not deemed safe, for example, for people with kidney issues. Others have been linked to liver toxicity, cardiovascular, or nervous system problems. Also, supplements can interact with prescription meds, changing their action, which in some cases can have devastating effects. So it's absolutely not a given that natural equals safe. We have to be careful with these appeals to emotion. Another common buzzword is science-based or science-backed. By itself, this doesn't mean anything. Sometimes on these pages, they'll point to a study of one of the ingredients of the proprietary blend. But the concoction being sold with 4 or 5 or 10 ingredients might not have the same effect as the isolated component. Ingredients can counteract each other. They can have inhibitory effects. They can have synergistic effects. They can have detrimental effects that you don't see with the isolated component. So you have to test the actual thing that you're selling. Now, of course, the influencer could just sell you the isolated ingredient that has been tested, but then it wouldn't be proprietary, right? You could buy that anywhere. The proprietary blend goes for 10 times the price, you see? So in order to sell you something special, they come up with this unique blend, but then they don't test the unique blend. They point you to the test of the thing that's not unique, right? It's trying to have it both ways. Also, the studies that are shown on these sales pages are often of very poor quality. Sometimes it's just an in vitro study in a test tube or in cell culture or in a lab animal. There's no guarantee that the same thing is going to take place in a human being. My point is not that everybody's out to get you. Let's be paranoid. Just be aware that these sales pitches are more about emotion and psychology than they are about science. If you're selling me an $80 bottle of pills, don't tell me some story. Test it properly and show me that it's safe. Show me a published trial in human beings taking your pill, your supplement, period. That's not a high bar. That's non-negotiable. So that's the proprietary formulations. If there's no evidence, it might help you, it might hurt you, or it might do nothing and just be money down the drain. It's a coin toss. Now, the common supplements that are branded like a mineral or a vitamin, those are even more straightforward. Usually, you can find a lot more evidence for those. Now, the influencer didn't produce that evidence, but it's already out there because it's a common supplement. Now, of course, you can get the exact same thing from 1,000 other sources, usually at a fraction of the cost because you're paying the guy's profit margin, right? You're essentially paying for his or her marketing. Now, this might be completely okay. If you really like the influencer and you think they're doing a great job and you want to reward them and you decide, okay, I'm not going to buy from all these other generic sources. I'm going to buy from this person. Almost like a donation, like a Patreon, right? Completely fine. There's nothing wrong with that, as long as you know you're doing it. In general, with supplements, it's good to bear in mind they're very loosely regulated. At least in the US, that's the system I know best. If you're somewhere else and the reality there is very different as far as supplements from the United States, I'd love to hear it. Please share with everybody in the comments. In the United States, supplement manufacturers don't need to demonstrate efficacy. So the supplement might do absolutely nothing, still completely fine to sell it. You don't even need to demonstrate safety for your specific supplement. In fact, if your supplement doesn't contain a new ingredient, you don't even need to register your supplement with the FDA. You can go straight to selling. There's also no restriction on dose. So you can sell a supplement that contains 1,000 times the daily recommended value of a vitamin per pill, for one pill. That's completely legal. You can sell that as long as it says that on the label. Even crazier, the actual amount of the compound present in the pills is not enforced. So a component might be present at the amount specified on the label. There might be less of it. It might be undetectable. There might be more of it. One study looked at vitamin D supplements, and the actual content measured in the pills ranged from 9% to 146% of the dose stated on the label. Imagine you're on blood pressure lowering meds, and the dose prescribed to you by your doctor is 10 milligrams, but then the pill that you're taking might contain 10, might contain 1, might contain 100. That would be insanity. The control for prescription meds is actually much tighter, but with supplements, it's the wild, wild west. Another problem is contamination. There's one report that found trace elements of lead, arsenic, mercury, cadmium, or pesticides in 93% of supplements tested. I know people hate on Big Pharma, and hey, it's not undeserved because they pull plenty of shenanigans, but the reality is the regulations for pharma are much tighter than for supplements. You have to conduct safety trials. You have to show efficacy. You have to show that your drug provides a benefit that outweighs the risks. The amount of the drug present in the pill is much more reliable. None of this applies to supplements. I'm in a privileged position. I don't have any connections to either. I don't sell prescription meds or supplements. So I get to just sit back and watch all of this. But I laugh when people say, I don't take my prescription meds because I don't trust Big Pharma. They just want your money. So instead, I take these supplements over here. Supplements are a multi-billion dollar industry. It's not exactly a charity. And peak irony, the pharmaceutical industry has a big stake in supplements. They have their hand in that cookie jar because they're not dumb. Supplements are cheap to make and they're virtually unregulated. So you can get away with stuff there that Big Pharma can only dream of. My position is that healthy skepticism is warranted both for Big Pharma and big supplements. And I'm not anti-supplement. I think there are situations where it's legitimate. It's reasonable to supplement. For example, you have a nutrient deficiency. You measure the levels of something, an important molecule, and they're dangerously low. So you take a supplement to normalize that. Okay. Or your diet doesn't provide you enough of a certain nutrient for some reason. So you supplement that on the side. That's reasonable. And I'm completely open to other situations, other benefits, if the evidence is there. But a lot of these sales on the internet are based on emotion, usually fear. Maybe I'm not getting enough of this nutrient, so let me get the supplement just in case. Can't hurt to get a little extra, right? Biology doesn't always work like that. Hypervitaminosis is a real thing. You can get too much of certain vitamins, certain minerals sometimes, and it can cause problems. Now, some things your body is really good at getting rid of if you take in too much, like water-soluble vitamins, for example, but other things can accumulate and create problems if they're excessive. So just healthy skepticism. Before you swipe the credit card, press them for the evidence. At the end of the day, it's your health on the line. What about vitamin K supplements? That's a common question, and we covered that recently in depth. I'll put that right here. And if you're tired of supplements, here's a video about autophagy. Do we need to increase that? Is it dangerous? Is it safe? Lots of mythology there as well. Check those out. I'll meet you over there. Bye.